Hey everyone, we're almost ending 2020, so what better way to do it than with some art? So I've been working with these three canvases for the last couple of weeks anyway when I've got time. So I just thought I'd do a real-time video today so you can see how I just keep adding layers and colours. So I will talk a little bit, but I'm not that great. So what I start off with is basically it's just artist canvas, and these are acrylic paints, and I build them up by layering the different colors of paints in random patterns. So everyone always has a different style of painting or a technique. So some people will draw out a design or think of a design before they actually put it onto canvas. I'm not like that. I will just paint straight to canvas and whatever happens, happens. So all of the things that you see me doing, the patterns, adding in the different lines and shapes, no thought process behind it. So it's just me doing whatever. So I've never had any training with art, and I work full time. So art is or has always been a passion. And I've given up lots of times throughout the years, just thinking that, you know, I'm not good enough to be an artist, because, you know, the worst thing is if you can't sell it, then, you know, you think that nobody likes what you're doing. I'm at the attitude now that I've reached 40, and, you know, with all the crap that's been going down, I just don't care anymore. So I'm going to just paint, I'm going to draw, I'm going to do whatever I feel that I feel like doing. So I suffer from depression and anxiety, so some days I'm planning to get out here and make all these exciting, you know, YouTube channels, and I'm going to do all these videos, and then other days I honestly can't be bothered to get out of bed. So what I found is, for me, is art is it's relaxing. It helps me to, I think, sometimes quiet down all the thoughts that race through my head. So a lot of the time I figure that my art can reflect how I'm feeling. So I don't like to sit there and analyze what I'm feeling. My technique is actually heavy metal rock, which might surprise a lot of people if you look at me, to think why would, but it works for me. I tend to think a lot when I'm doing art, and it just, if I just want to quiet and just concentrate on the art, I find that the music actually helps me. I'll burn some incense and stuff as well. But a lot of the times, like, I struggle, I'm tired, I'm very tired from some health issues. So even today, I just want to sleep, and I thought, you know what, I'm not going to miss an opportunity to paint. So I painted these canvases a few weeks ago, and then we've had Christmas, and we've had, you know, all of the end of year activities at work and so on. Today is probably the first day I've gotten out here in a really long time. So I've just been adding, after all the acrylic dries and all the swirly patterns, I then actually use Posca textures. So you can get Poscas in all different sizes, so it just depends on the tip size. So for example, this one is 3 mil. So it just tells you the thickness that comes. It's something that I've just found is that I enjoy adding fine detail with the Poscas, and I just enjoy layering colors over colors and lines over lines. These paintings actually take weeks. So when someone looks at it, you know, they don't realize that sometimes you go over the same spot, you know, 10 times, because you put down black, then you'll put the white, and then you might put a green and then a gray, and then you might use a finer point texture and then go over it again. So it can be layers upon layers, and sometimes I just don't know when to stop. It's just when I feel that I'm ready to stop. So I actually numbered the canvases this morning, because I'd left it that long. I didn't even know which order the canvases were in, so that was a bit stupid. I was doing this. I've always thought that if you're gonna do art, like, it's good to have a recognizable style, or, you know, where people can look at your art and enjoy it. For me, it's about making art that I enjoy. So, you know, I'm fortunate enough that if I wanted to paint a horse, for example, I could paint a horse, or I could then do an abstract, or I could, you know, do a cartoon. And I mean, I would love to really be getting into children's illustrator, and one day hope to do illustrations for books. I enjoy all sorts of art styles, and I mean, there are so many talented people out there. Obviously, I don't know a lot of the techniques that you can use, and I'm sure there's better ways to use materials. I'm sure there's better ways to, you know, utilize and to draw. I don't trace anything, so I mean, a lot of people always debate, can you trace something? Does that technically, you know, still mean it's art? I mean, I'm not interested in any of that stuff. If you want to trace, trace, but that's not, like I said, I don't think about it, I don't plan it, I just do whatever. So it's whatever works for you. I don't think you need to be in any sort of category where you have to do something a certain way. Is this the right way to use Posca paints? Who knows? Is it right to be applying it onto canvas? I don't know. It works for me, and I've done some of the house, the whimsical houses, and the busy cities, and they've worked fantastic for me, and I've enjoyed them and had a lot of feedback from people that enjoy those. I find that I wanted to make something that, you know, it was my sort of style, and I honestly try to simplify. I try to simplify my art. I try to make it less busy and less, you know, so much detail. And I find for me, it feels like it's just the base coat, or it's not the full thing. So as you can see that one there, I've added a lot of black. So I'm going to do that now with the other pieces while I talk. So then I've noticed that over the years, in a lot of them, whether I've been drawing on the MDF or whether it's on my cartoons, that I always seem to have sections of really busy, whether it's patterns on the mermaids, on the MDF shapes, patterns of heaps of busy color, busy patterns. So I just came up with this concept of putting it onto a canvas. And I'm actually really enjoying it. I enjoy the freedom because I can do whatever I want. And there's no limit to it. So I can make it as busy as I want. When I was doing the houses, it was a bit harder, like, you know, to keep it from being boring. But I guess this is only the second abstract one like this that I did. You would have seen a video of a really long canvas, or it was on my Facebook page, Awesomeness Designs, that I just did a couple weeks ago, and it really works. So this is something that I'm going to really try and concentrate on when I'm feeling good mentally and I can get out here, because like I said, it takes a long time just with all the layers and stuff like that. So I'm gonna keep going here, adding more black. So what I thought was, if you can see, this one seems to have brought it together. It was missing that black. Whereas the one here that I haven't done yet, it just see how it hasn't come together. It needs that black like that to bring it together. So you know what? Your color is really important to make sure that you bring it together. So you've got to have the right balance of colors. So that's what I find is really important. I'm going to keep going here. I'm going to continue on with these three canvases, and then, you know, later on I'm going to put a video up with all the pictures of progress photos that I've taken, and make a video so that you can maybe see how it started from the beginning and then what it ends like when I finish. Hopefully I'll get it done today, so that's my plan. So yeah, have a great day everybody. If I don't post it up tonight, then hopefully it will be over the couple of days where I've got a couple of days on break. Everyone have a great, happy rest of the holiday season and new year, and I'll see you soon. Thank you.